Hi, I'm Rob from Salsify, and I want to talk today about slow data and fast data, and how they need different processes and technologies to manage them. This conversation is pretty important because I think there's a point of friction often between the e-commerce teams and the digital teams within brand manufacturers and IT organizations that have been supporting the data governance and data management and storage and processes and procedures around all of their information for many, many years. Oftentimes what you'll see is somebody who's close to Grainger or close to Amazon or close to Ingram Micro or close to Walmart, one of these retailers that changes their requirements frequently, come to IT and ask for a system to better manage their e-commerce data, the product titles, the image galleries, the descriptions, the search attribution keywords, the attributes that drive the navigation on the site and other aspects of findability, the enhanced content, things like that. And often the response they get is, we already have a system for storing data. Whether it's the ERP system that they've added onto, whether it's a master data management system, whether it's a old legacy enterprise PIM from 10 years ago, they believe that they've invested in a system that manages product information, and why not just continue using the existing product information system that they've got? Now, the issue with that is that those systems were built to manage a specific kind of data, which I want to call slow data. Slow data is not a pejorative term. It doesn't mean it's bad data. Slow data is actually, in many ways, the most important data in your organization. It's the stuff that you absolutely cannot screw up, right? It's the high cost of failure data. If you get your ingredient information wrong when you put it out on the labels on the products, that can cause you lawsuits, right? If you get your shipping and logistics information wrong, it means that your products can be damaged in shipping, costing the company millions of dollars. You have to get it right. So governance and process and control is really important. This is also data that doesn't change after product development. Once your product is live, the size of the product, the weight of the product, the ingredients of the product, those don't change that much. So what you want is you want a system to store that data that you can trust, that absolutely you know has correct information in it all the time. That's what I call slow data. Slow data means that it's not fast to change. Now on the digital shelf, for brand manufacturers, this is new in the last several years. A lot of brand manufacturers 5 years ago didn't put really a lot of investment into the packaging of their products on the digital shelf, the images and product titles and whatnot. It's a relatively new phenomenon. And what you see is on the digital shelf, a lot of the data that consumers see is fast data. The rules about what a retailer or a distributor will allow you to use for a product title or a description or a feature bullet change all the time. Amazon just this year has had many changes that impact the consumer experience, impact search rankings, impact conversion rates, things like making A-plus content free, changing the links of product titles, changing the number of feature bullets, enabling you to have hero images that span the entire product detail page. There's a whole bunch that have changed in the last year. And you don't know what they're going to change next month, right? So the types of information and the rules about that information and what you need to develop internally to succeed is in constant flux. It's highly volatile. Not only is it highly volatile, but it's also not kind of as important to get absolutely ironclad 100% correct. If you have a misspelling in your product title, that's okay. It's easily correctable. Just send a note and replace it, right? It's not a be-all end-all. It's not going to ruin shipments. So the requirements change all the time with fast data. Also, the algorithms change all the time. Amazon's and Walmart's and Google's and Grainger's search algorithms are constantly being tweaked for higher conversion rate. Your product that's performing really well this week could perform really badly next week. And the only way to address that is to update your product content to meet the new algorithms. And they're changing in ways that are not predictable to you. Agile responses are required. So the type of process that you need internally and the type of technology that you need internally to manage the e-commerce data that's so quickly changing and so volatile, it's different than what you need to manage slow data. Now, the retailers and distribution partners need both from you, but from an internal management perspective, they're very different. And this is what I think is at the heart of any type of disagreement that you see between digital and e-commerce teams and IT organizations that have been the traditional data stewards within a large brand manufacturer. So I wanted to call this up because I think that it'll help make the conversation a little bit easier between the teams. This is a new requirement that was not really present a few years ago, and it's one that companies need to bring technology to bear to really address.